quick newsflash to say I've arrived in one piece. Good lodgings with a nice landlady.
Fact is, I'm just a teeny-weeny bit choosy. Particularly, you see what I mean. But I'm always ready. Be prepared, as we used to say in the Girl Guides.
A bit crazy, but okay. Sort of everyone's favourite aunt. Very cosy.
Very cosy. All my guests that to treat my house as home, home from home, dear.
Don't let my awful sisters drag you down. Joke. Love.
Humor doesn't have to be the same as mine. Then I'm afraid you're going to be a bit disturbed by what goes on. And by the way, if any of you attempt to think it's all pretty far-fetched, then you should stop and think, and ask yourself seriously whether such a thing as this could really happen. The answer is yes, of course it does. Even to you.
Thank you. train gets louder and the lights get brighter. And all of a sudden, I wake up in a hospital bed to the sound of my heart beating. I hear my heart slow. Tracks in the dead of the night. To my left, a fox scurries through a bush. To my right, an owl looks onto a nearby field with wide eyes and feathers as pale as the moon. Behind me, I leave only what exists in photos taken and letters written. At my feet are stones with numbers on them. I pick one up and realise they are days. Each stone represents a day wasted. Ahead, I see pale blue flowers growing. Train rattling in the distance, echoes and vibrations. A light approaches at speed, but I feel no need to worry. I look to the sky, and shooting stars are leaving beautiful trails above my head. The train gets louder, and the lights get brighter, and all of a sudden, I wake up in a hospital bed.
Until then, goodbye. On a back to today, and at 4:45, the Monday edition of Blue Peter.
Thank you. Thank you.